AI is driving everybody crazy. And yes, coders are secretly leveraging it and swiftly shipping code, but they won't tell you. The question is, are you able to code too using the help of the AI? Let's see about it. Today we're building a blog website, a portfolio you can use to show off your cybersecurity projects and write-ups. And if you're a dev, you can ship 100 times more with AI. The best part? We'll host it live on the web using GitHub, and you'll have your own URL for your website completely free of charge.
Wow!
All you need is just some basic HTML knowledge, and to stick around till the end of the video. Here's the thing. AI these days makes coding super easy. But here's the catch. If you're going to use AI to write code, first of all, you need to know the context of the language. You really have to at least do something regarding code and the project context you're working on. Then build from that, fix bugs, and search on Google. Otherwise, you're just shooting in the dark. Ranting with AI? You might end up being an over-caffeinated wannabe hacker who thinks blinking text is still cool. Trust me, nobody wants to see that cybercrime profile. Right here is my rendered web page with raw HTML. I could host it as is, but let's face it, buddy. First impressions matter. Sadly, people instead judge a book by its cover. If you want to make an impact, you need some good UI and UX for your site. And keep it simple, stupid. Kiss it. That's why we need CSS to transform it from this to this cyber-savvy site. Truth is, a lot of cybersecurity folks can barely write HTML, used to only the dev tools injecting SQL payloads, and really suck at CSS. To be honest, me too. It's like trying to crack 256-bit encryption on a ThinkPad with very low specs. Theoretically possible, but painfully slow. But hey, thanks to PureCode for making this video possible, we can now suck less at CSS and front-end skills in general. PureCode AI is a super cool UI-focused tool highly in demand for front-end devs, full-stack devs, and everyone in the tech community. By creating an account, you get to choose your best stack to get the job done. From Angular, a TypeScript-based framework, to Tailwind CSS and React, simply describe what you want. Generate production-ready UI code, and you'll ship code faster from Monday to Friday without a hassle. You can integrate your own unique themes and easily build UI components that align with your products. Seamlessly generate and update components by editing the text directly. Yes, there's an extension for your favorite code editor, VS Code or Cursor. And the best part is, there's a free trial for everybody, so give it a go now and code happier. Oh, the link will be in the description. All right, back to the blog. Let's get practical. First things first, we need a GitHub repository for our project. If you don't have a GitHub account yet, now's the perfect time to create one. It's quick, easy, and free. Once you're logged in, under Repositories, click New to create your first public repo, and for the name, use your not a hacker username, your actual GitHub username, followed by .github.io. This naming convention is crucial. It has to be your exact username, followed by the GitHub Pages domain to work correctly. A brief description if you'd like. It's optional, but why not? And sure to set the repository to public. Remember, we want the world to see your awesome blog. You can choose to add a README file and a license if you want. Finally, click Create Repository. Then, copy the URL and clone it to your local machine into some folder. Oh, Git is pre-installed on the Linux OS. Windows users, if you're having trouble with that, be sure to first install Git, then you can clone. And hey, is this your first Git command? New to HTML? Don't worry, we're going to keep it simple, stupid. First, create a new file called index.html in our project folder. We're using everybody's favorite VS Code. This will be the main page of the website. Now, here's a cool trick. Type bang and hit enter. Boom. You've just created a basic HTML structure. Let's break it down. This is the backbone of a web page. The head tag section holds all the meta info, while everything else goes in the body. That's what visitors will actually see when rendered. And all code sits in the HTML tags with doc type declared at the beginning. Now, here's where things get interesting. Let's get coding right away. Except we do have a sidekick, a co-pilot, our assistant, PureCode AI. Open up that PureCode AI extension, or do it from your browser. With a theme selected, we're gonna opt for HTML and Tailwind CSS. Well, we'll code our website to look like this one at the speed of wind, just with these crispy prompts. Or it could be any structure you can imagine. First is the navigation bar. List out a few components, click Generate. This takes a minute or two, depending on your internet connection, while you play some snake game. And here we have previews of three to select from with this nicely written responsive code. Next, we can tackle the hero section, and you might need to duplicate, adding in the rest. Footer and context section, blog, projects. And here's the cool part. You can select a few components, prompt to edit, and make changes till you're happy. And finally, copy and paste to the editor. Our code is ready and responsive, except for the burger menu. Let's give it a brain. The UI is clean and beautiful, I must say. Ooh, is it? And some UX engineers find hamburgers a con, but I'm not against them. We need this sort of toggling functionality too. Well, I wrote that in the script tag right here at the end of the body. Yes, this is how you can add JavaScript directly to your HTML when using Tailwind, vanilla CSS, or Bootstrap without linking a separate file. We won't go much into the core details of these CSS types and all, but this is what this not good JavaScript code does at the moment. In layman's terms, it creates a hover effect, and when the burger menu button is clicked, it just shows and hides it for easy navigation of this placeholder website template. I finally edited and created a GitHub repo for all of us to play around with and make it a portfolio website by just feeding in your blog and project's info, or use it as a reference to learn more or build from PureCode. Just be sure you understand your code. Okay, Tailwind initially applies images directly from Unsplash, which is cool, as these placeholders for the blogs, projects, and the Who Am I profile picture. All these images are specified with the image tag using the source attribute. These links can also be replaced before the href in the anchor tags, the A tag which hyperlinks everything, including email or just anything that can be linked. You can replace view all and read more with links to your GitHub repo, account or your Medium account, or just any site that links to your other blogging. Alternatively, you can write every blog and project section in the HTML or on separate HTML pages like this first cyber-savvy web page we used vanilla CSS for, and link images and all resources directly from your local machine, depending on your project context. For a basic portfolio, it's better to keep it as one HTML file like this one. Now for the most interesting part, hosting our website. With this single HTML file, all we need is to upload it to GitHub. We can just drag and drop it, then commit changes. But hey buddy, let's go back to terminal because I promised everyone new will know some Git. And these are one of the most used Git commands. Fire up your CMD or VS Code terminal in your project directory, and Git status will show if our work is staged. And this is red in VS Code means not. So we can just do git add dot to add everything. Some prefer git add dash all or git add, and the file name. This is helpful in cases where you have some private keys. Anyway, our HTML file is staged. Then we can do git commit dash m and the commit message. And finally git push origin and specify the branch. It's main by default if you didn't make any changes. Now we pushed everything, and upon refreshing our GitHub page, we delivered the HTML file. To make sure the URL works perfectly, head over to settings up here in the repo, then pages on the left menu. Before we visit our up and running website, we are deploying this from a branch, so be sure to set this to our branch name, the main branch. Now the moment of truth. Click on visit site. Ooh, our website is live. With a URL, but with this github.io domain, no problem, it's free. That's what matters. Okay, we've created a sleek, responsive website using Tailwind CSS CDN and a touch of JavaScript. We leveraged the power of AI with PureCode to speed up our development process. It has a free trial, by the way. And we hosted it all for free on GitHub Pages. And yes, you can use AI. I personally use LLMs to explain some new concepts, ethical ones, that I'm learning. And if I'm really willing to grasp it, which should be the goal, I go ahead and check out the docs on Google that talk about that, then just build from that, and so on. Speaking of, GitHub Pages has a sort of a CDN, Jekyll with templates that you can customize to host static websites and blog literally zero code, just Markdown, and our website is a front end. So how do we host the back end too? Let's see about this next on Let's Build, as we secure, hack, and create cyber wonders. All right, cyber buddy. If you learned something, don't forget to smash that like button. Subscribe and share the video to Liam and Franklin, your other cyber buddies. Leave a comment if you have to. I'm all circuits. See you in the next one. Happy coding.